Yohanan Plesner is the president of the Israel Democracy Institute and a former member of the Israeli Knesset. He joins me now from Hod Hasharon near Tel Aviv. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thanks for having me this morning.
So, what was your initial response to news of this surprise attack by Hamas and, of course, the sophistication involved with coordinated attacks by land, air and sea?
Well, clearly, Israel was surprised. We were surprised, and Hamas declared a war on Israel, a horrific war that includes goals of killing families, killing youngsters, youth, and festivals, basically killing as many Israeli civilians as possible as part of a broader goal of Hamas to destroy the state of Israel and to kill all Jews. I mean, it sounds horrific, but there's a plan, there's a doctrine, it's supported by Iran, it's supported by Hezbollah, and the terrible atrocities are now being surfaced. We're discovering how entire families, father, mother, three kids, three daughters, girls, boys, old people, Holocaust survivors, were both killed, slaughtered, taken hostage to Gaza. So it's a genocidal, a jihadist organization supported by Iran, perpetrated a horrific attack, continues to perpetrate such attacks. Just a few hours ago, they sent dozens of Hamas operatives into a kibbutz in southern Israel. So the fighting continues to go on, and there's only one way to deal with it, and it's basically to absolutely destroy and crush Hamas's capabilities to launch any kind of warfare. The previous doctrine of we can live side by side next to this a tiger, a monster, and hopefully it will tame itself, this doctrine has failed, and Israel is now going to embark on a new path, a path that means that we need to basically crush right. Hamas capabilities, and this will be hard and long.
Right. And at this stage, it does have to be said, there's no evidence that Iran is behind this, but I certainly understand your speculation on that point, given the history here. So I want to ask you, though, given...
On this point, yes. just on the Iranian point, Hamas and Iran are allies. Iran pours money, equipment, doctrine into Hamas on an ongoing basis. Right. They established yes. Hamas and Islamic Jihad as a front base to try and, again, implement their doctrine of annihilating Israel. Specifically on this attack, whether Iran knew when and where and exactly the tactics, I don't know for sure.
So given the sophistication of this operation, and we haven't ever seen Hamas as sophisticated as this, how was it possible, and so many people involved, how is it possible that Israeli intelligence didn't see this attack coming? And why was the initial response to the attack so slow? Even its own citizens are asking these questions.
Look, those are excellent questions. And obviously, we will have to think about them very seriously and develop responses, because there was both an intelligence failure and an operational failure. But right now, it's not the time to delve into, immerse oneself in those questions. Right now is the time to restore security and respond back very forcefully. There will come a time for us to conduct the lessons learned and improve the systems and ensure that such a thing doesn't recur again. But this is not the time. We're in the midst of fighting. Israel mobilized hundreds of thousands of reservists. Israelis are united across the board. You know, I've been also on CNN just a few weeks and perhaps months ago talking about internal Israeli disputes about our democratic makeup. This is all now set aside. We're all together, we're all united. The reservists showed up in 150%, even people who are not called up showed up. Israelis from all walks of life are volunteering, are assisting. We're seeing beautiful instances of heroism, of fighting. So Israel will prevail, but clearly we were surprised, by a jihadist, murderous, barbaric organization, and they will pay the price.
And Hamas is claiming to be holding more than 100 hostages. We don't know if that is in actual fact the case, but how will the Israeli government rescue these hostages and bring them home safely?
Well, it's again a very good question. The assumption that there's unfortunately more than 100 hostages is a safe assumption. Both civilians, old people, women, children, and soldiers, all of them are being held. Israel, on the one hand, needs to restore security, restore stability, exact the price, a very dear price on Hamas, reduce its capabilities, and at the same time, we will have to negotiate for the release of those prisoners. Nevertheless, Hamas immediately needs to release old people, children. It's basically a major, major violation of any kind of humanitarian code, and obviously laws of war. They're being violated and perpetrating war crimes right, left, and center. And one has to understand, and this is very, very important, Hamas conducts a war crime by situating its capabilities within the civilian population. And we will have no choice. As we attack Hamas, there will be collateral damage. So all civilians now should detach themselves from Hamas operatives, because we're going to go after these operatives and there will be collateral damage. And we have to understand it, and there's no other option.
Let's hope all those hostages come home safely. We are praying for them. Yohanan Plesner, president of the Israel Democracy Institute, many thanks for joining us. Appreciate it.
Thanks for having me.